What's going on, everybody? Chuck here, and I hope that you are having a fantastic day today. In this video, we're going to talk about why I think turf-type tall fescue deserves more love than it gets. So now, before we get into the meat and potatoes of this video, I want to first go over what some may consider the last step of a lawn renovation, or close to the last step of a lawn renovation. That is actually putting down your grass seed. We've done everything up until this point, put down new soil, well, killed everything off, put down new soil, dethatched, all this kind of thing. And so now the bed is ready for grass seed, and I went, unsurprisingly, with turf type tall fescue. I went with the Triple Threat blend from Southern Seeds Incorporated. They're based out of North Carolina. It's a blue tag grass seed, so which means it's really high quality, no weed seeds, no crop seeds, high germination rate, and it was recently tested. I believe it was like June or July of this year. So a really good high quality grass seed. The Triple Threat means that it has three different cultivars of fescue, and it promotes disease resistance, heat and drought tolerance, and a dark, deep green color, which is pretty much all the things you really want with any kind of grass type for the most part. And with that Triple Threat blend, I went with 8 pounds per 1,000 square feet. Now you might be saying, Chuck, that's not a whole lot of grass seed for a full lawn renovation, and you're absolutely right. I bought a 50 pound bag of Southern Seed Triple Threat mix for about, I think it was around $100. I am giving away quite a bit of that grass seed to my father-in-law and a friend of mine who lives in this neighborhood that were also doing some overseeding, and I wanted to share the wealth because grass seed is ridiculously expensive these days. So I knew I needed a little bit more, so I went with a single cultivar, giving me a total of 4 different types of turf type tall fescue. I went with the Millennium LS from United Seeds, and the LS stands for lateral spreading or a rhizominous tall fescue. Now please, don't get me wrong, I'm not stupid, I know how this works. Just because it says it's rhizominous tall fescue, I cannot and do not expect it to work like a Kentucky bluegrass or on the warm season side, a Bermuda, where it's gonna fill in any sort of damaged areas. I don't need to put any more grass seed down because it will just fill in itself. It's not gonna work up to that level, but even if I get just a little bit of rhizominous action out of this, this cultivar of tall fescue, and it heals and just spreads just a little bit, I'm gonna be okay with it, because over time it will take less and less seed to overseed in the fall months. So, but that's way down the road. Like I said, not expecting it to work right away. And with that, I went at 3 pounds per thousand, thus giving me a total of 11 pounds per thousand of new grass seed being put down on my bare turf.
Hey Charlie, how's it going?
What's up?
Throwing down some grass seed? Fusca?
Fescue.
All right. Do a pH level test?
Not this time.
Should always do a soil test before throwing down grass seed.
It's a great point.
Quick tip, Timmy, out!
Along with the grass seed, I went ahead and used the back of my rake, and I raked in the seed in the first half to quarter inch of the new topsoil I put in, so it has awesome seed to soil contact. I applied fertilizer, which I went with the Green County Fertilizers Seed Starter Pack, which is 16-21-2 Green Pop at 15 ounces per thousand with 3 ounces per thousand of RGS. Then on top of that, I used peat moss. It wasn't really a necessary step because even though the whole lawn is a big bare area, because I put down the new soil and I raked in the grass seed gently, it was already covered, but I just wanted a little bit of organic material. And if peat moss does anything else, it's a good indicator on whether or not your seed is drying out or not. So before we get into the meat of this video, I first want to say thank you so much for watching. Please give me a thumbs up if you don't mind. Subscribe if you also don't mind, because those things make a big difference in the growth of my channel. Several weeks ago, before I actually put down grass seed, I put a post here on my community page here on YouTube, and I also posted in several Facebook groups asking about turf type tall fescue. If you have turf type tall fescue, why'd you go with turf type tall fescue? What do you like about it? What don't you like about it? If you don't have turf type tall fescue and you could have turf type tall fescue, why'd you decide to go in a different route? What are some things you like, don't like, rumors that you've heard, and all these kind of things? So that way, we can just sort of, I could just see how everything lined up. And Unsurprisingly, everything sort of lined up really well with what people liked about it and what people didn't like about it, as well as some of those sort of contradicting one another. Now let's talk about why I personally really like turf type tall fescue. And the number one main reason I like tall fescue is, in my opinion, here in East Tennessee, where you live, it may act completely different. Now here in East Tennessee, turf type tall fescue, when you do everything right, that's feed it regularly like you're supposed to, give it water when it needs it, cut it regularly, it is a year-around grass. I don't care what anybody says. Like I said, this is all from my observations of having turf-type tall fescue. It greens up pretty darn early in the spring. As long as you water it during the summer and you don't have to put a bunch of water on it, if you do the inch and a half, you know, if you do a, the way I do my watering is actually, you know, every 3 days at half an inch. And that gives me an inch and a half every 9 days, really. But still, even at that point, it is more than enough water to keep the grass thriving in these hot Tennessee summers that we have. And it thrives and it grows. So I'm mowing it maybe once or twice a week during the summer months. And then we get to the fall, which it thrives in the fall, obviously, because it's a cool season grass. And then in the summer, while yes, it does, there is a little bit of dormancy that goes on. I don't ever water it in the winter months. I don't feed it any fertilizer in the winter months. So it's kind of left on its own, but I could still probably mow it maybe twice a month and take something off where it's not necessarily a charity mow. And it maintains its color a lot better than say something like a Bermuda or some other warm season grass. So in my opinion, turf type tall fescue, it holds its green throughout the year. So therefore it is a year round grass type in my opinion. And now these next few things that I'm gonna talk about are things that were also shared in the various posts that I made across social media. Another thing that I like about tall fescue and a lot of people like about tall fescue is that it has disease resistance, which is what I was talking about. It's also contradictory because a lot of people think it suffers too much from disease. A big thing that tall fescue is known to get is brown patch. I have dealt with it, but as long as you keep up with your fungicide applications, which you should do with any grass type that you have, you can keep things under control. But even with the more modern cultivars, that brown patch, that disease tends to be really small and located and not a widespread breakout in your lawn. I also had some rust this year. So there's some things that are my fault and not necessarily the grass's fault. So yes, it is susceptible, but for the most part, it is mostly disease resistant as I haven't dealt with a whole lot of disease or fungus in my time with fescue. Another thing I really like about turf type tall fescue is its heat and drought tolerance. It does phenomenally in the summer. Even if you don't water all the time, there's a lot of lawns in my neighborhood that people do treat really well and take care of it, and they don't necessarily water it as much as I do. And they still had a really green lawn throughout the summer. Now, some of the really hot days that we had or hot spells that we had, there was a little bit of graying going on, but you throw a little bit of water on that bad boy and it's back up to being normal. So, in my opinion, it does really well in the disease and or in the heat and drought tolerance, which goes to what I was saying earlier about it being a year-round grass. Whereas if here in East Tennessee, something like a Kentucky bluegrass or a perennial ryegrass would definitely struggle with our summers here in East Tennessee, turf type tall fescue seems to do really, really well. Another thing that I really like about turf type tall fescue, and a lot of people do, is that it stands up really well to foot traffic. It is not a delicate grass type, which also tends to lend into the cons of turf type tall fescue that we'll talk about in a minute. But it holds up really well to foot traffic. It's a wider blade than your perennial ryegrass, your Kentucky bluegrass, and it's just a much hardier grass type. So it does really well in high traffic areas. So therefore, in my opinion, it's a really good grass type if you have kids or anything like that, because it is thick, it is lush, and it can handle kids playing, running, rolling around on it and causing all sorts of mayhem on your lawn, and it will stand up to most anything that you can throw at it. Now let's quickly get into the things that people have said they don't like about turf type tall fescue. And like I mentioned earlier, people say it's too susceptible to disease. If you keep up with your fungicide applications, you should be fine. But something people do have a problem with it, and it sort of went into with the durability of it or the standing up well to foot traffic, is that because it is a more hardy grass type than say a Kentucky bluegrass or perennial ryegrass, is that it's not as comfortable to walk on as those other grass types. Those other grass types, they feel really good on the feet. Now, cutting tall fescue up at 4 inches like you should in the summer, it's a very cool and pleasant feeling. If it's really hot outside and you walk on your nice cool grass, well shaded ground because of that tall fescue, it feels really nice because of the temperature. But yes, because it's also a clumping type plant, you're not getting this spreading thing, this spreading grass type where it just sort of spreads and fills in. So there's no real individual clumps of grass with these other these other grass types that you get with tall fescue. So it's not as pleasant to walk on as say something else. And therefore it's also never going to be completely level because you have all these various plants basically around your lawn. So you're always going to have a little bit of bumpiness to go in your turf. But another problem people have with it is the color. This is completely up to you. You know, it's whatever you like in a color of grass. In my opinion, yes, it's not as dark as say a Kentucky bluegrass or a perennial ryegrass, but it's still a very pleasant shade of green. If you drive around a neighborhood that has a lot of really good fescue lawns that are fertilized well and watered well, to me, it's what I constitute in my brain as what a nice green lawn should look like. So that's up to you. What do you like in your color of green? You know, I don't find that as a negative or a positive because it depends what you like in your coloring of grass. So people don't like it. That's up to you. Meh. Now, what I think is the biggest con of turf type tall fescue, along with what the majority of people that have fescue or decide not to go with fescue, and that's not self-repairing. Even with these LS or rhizomatous tall fescues, lateral spreading tall fescues, it's still not to the same level of a Kentucky bluegrass or a Bermuda grass. If you do have areas that die off in the summer or areas that die because of fungus or whatever the case may be, you decide to dig a giant hole, you can't just throw fertilizer and hope the grass is just gonna fill itself in like with these other grass types. You're just gonna have to put more seed down. And so like I said just before, that's gonna be more expensive over time because you have to keep putting down grass seed in thin areas or areas that die off or whatever the case may be. So it's not self-repairing like these other grass types, which is a negative, and I do buy into that. But hopefully over time, these lateral spreading or rhizomatous tall fescues really start to develop. The science behind them gets a little bit stronger. So maybe they do act a little bit more like a Kentucky bluegrass, maybe not as aggressive as a Bermuda, but a little bit more like a Kentucky bluegrass where eventually they do start to self-repair a little bit. So that definitely is a negative, and I'll yield that. So anyway, that is it for this video. Like I said, please feel free to comment below with any thoughts you have on tall fescue, pros or cons. I'll try to communicate back and forth with you, but let's keep it civil. Let's not be negative and mean about whatever grass type we choose to use. If you like Kentucky bluegrass and you hate tall fescue, that's fine, I don't care. But let's just be civil about it. So let's have a conversation down below on your thoughts on turf type tall fescue. Please don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe if you don't mind, because it does, like I said, make a really big difference on the growth of this channel. But anyway, I will see you all in the next video. Have a fantastic rest of your day, and God bless.